Welcome back. Big breaking news coming in. Massive corruption scandal has once again hit the Congress party. Corruption tamed on the Congress party. Rahul Gandhi's aide accused of 10 crore fraud. That's the charge. We have the document. This is by Medina Frozen Food Exports Private Limited, and this letter was addressed to Congress President Rahul Gandhi, and the subject line reads, fraud of 10 crores committed by Mr. Nadeem Javed, chairman of the Minority Department of All India Congress Committee. I have the letter. This is a massive, massive embarrassment for the Congress president. The complainant has preferred this complaint against Mr. Nadeem Javed, former MLA Jaunpur Sadar, UP, as well as the current chairperson of the Minority Department of the Congress, that the complainant is Haji Muhammad Yameen Qureshi, proprietor of Messrs. Media Frozen Food Exports Private Limited. It is stated that the complainant is a well-reputed businessman and a loyal citizen towards the Congress party in Khurja, Bulandshahr, Uttar Pradesh. And then it talks about how Mr. Nadeem Javed had once met the complainant, and the complainant had explained him his personal proposal to set up a slaughterhouse for slaughtering buffaloes in Khurja. Pursuant to which Mr. Nadeem Javed, the chairperson of the AICC minority cell, had demanded the complainant a sum of 10 crore rupees in cash for the purpose of obtaining the sanction. Very, very serious charges, Madhav, and everything is in black and white. This letter that was written to Rahul Gandhi, the national president of the Congress party.
Well, this is certainly embarrassing for the party, and this incident has taken place, we understand, outside the India Islamic Center on Lodhi Road in the national capital, where Nadeem Javed is seen there in that group over there, where he has been clearly beaten up by those individuals who claim that he had taken some kind of money in lieu of actually getting some permissions in relation to a slaughterhouse in Khurja in Uttar Pradesh, but had failed to do so. Now, this letter, as you were reading out from this fraud of 10 crores, as it's called, is what is behind this entire episode. And obviously, when this money was taken and the work was not done, all of these individuals clearly decided to take out their anger on Nadeem Javed, as is seen in those pictures there. So certainly, of course, a lot of explaining that Rahul Gandhi and the Congress party would have to do, because this person is an active functionary of the party. And of course, is this what the Congress party really stands for? Doesn't this take away from the Congress party's own, you know, attacks on the central government as far as the issues of corruption are concerned, when its own party members are accused of such acts? These are, of course, charges that are being made. This is a letter that we are putting out over here, a video that is coming out from the complainant, and clearly, of course, highlighting the very, very serious charges that this individual, Nadeem Javed, faces. In this light, of course, certainly a lot of answering, a lot of explaining that the Congress party would have to do, Pranesh, to come and explain exactly what the circumstances were, because this video really speaks for itself. There's an altercation over there. There's some kind of a physical fight as well, an argument as well. And in fact, you can see over there how Nadeem Javed is confronted by those individuals who had allegedly paid him to get some work done. But Nadeem Javed, of course, sat on that money, did not get any work done. And that's why you see them completely aggravated. So those are the serious charges that have been
Madhav, I want to make a couple of things very, very clear for our viewers, that this is a claim being made by the person who's written this letter. This is by Medina Frozen Food Private Limited. There is no date on the letter. We do not know when this letter was written to Congress President Rahul Gandhi. What we do know, according to this letter, that this gentleman handed over 7 crores in cash in order to get the final sanction approval on the proposed slaughterhouse. So, according to this letter, and we'll put that letter out also, Nadeem Javed, who's the AICC minority cell chairman, took 7 crores in cash from this gentleman, after which he did not allegedly do the work that he had promised, which is why he was roughed up outside the India Islamic Center by at least 5 to 6 men. That is the video, Madhav.
Well, absolutely. That's the context in which, really, of course, the fact that he did not return the total sum of 10 crores. And I just want to read out the specific details. It says in the third paragraph that the complainant immediately agreed to demands of Mr. Nadeem Javed, handed over a sum of 3 crores in cash at first, in 2 installments at his residence, D266 Defence Colony, Delhi, on 24/7/2015 in advance. After a few days of receipt of 3 crores in cash, Mr. Nadeem Javed contacted the complainant and demanded a further sum of 7 crore rupees in cash in order to get the final sanction / approval on the proposed slaughterhouse. Therefore, in view of the aforesaid demand, the complainant handed over a sum of 7 crores in cash to Mr. Nadeem Javed at his government allotted flat at Bokhandi Vidyak Nivas, Lucknow on the 12th of December 2015. Mr. Nadeem Javed had received a total sum of 10 crores in cash from the complainant on 12th of December. In pursuant to demands, he was supposed to get the government sanction approval for his factory / slaughterhouse. His tenure as an MLA of Jaunpur Sadar UP, however, promises made by Nadeem Javed were never fulfilled, and clearly, of course, he never acted or returned the total sum of 10 crore rupees to the complainant. Instead, Mr. Nadeem Javed had threatened the complainant of dire consequences. Mr. Nadeem Javed never attends the calls of the complainant nor meeting him, and of course, the complainant, of course, ready to prove whatever proof he has, bring it before all of these individuals who have been named. In this case, of course, the letter mentions it is titled to Rahul Gandhi, National President of the Indian National Congress. Over here, the subject is very much the same: fraud of 10 crores committed by Nadeem Javed, chairman of the minority department. So some very serious charges. We cannot, of course, vouch for the charges, Pranish, as you rightly said it. These are, when it comes to such political matters, the charges may or may not be true, but they are certainly very serious charges. The video speaks for itself about the kind of frustration of these individuals. The fact that they've written this letter also certainly speaks volumes, and certainly, of course, the matter needs to be probed as to whether there is any truth or any veracity in these very serious claims that are being made as far as the chairman of the minority department of the Congress is concerned, Pranesh.
Now, while the charges are very grave in nature, Madhav, let's also talk about the individual against whom these charges are made. We are talking about Nadeem Javed, who is a legislator and the chairman of the minority department of the All India Congress Committee. He is considered very, very close to the Congress president, Rahul Gandhi, Madhav.
Well, absolutely. There's no doubt at this point of time, Pranesh. Rahul Gandhi, ever since he's taken over as Congress president, has tried to ensure that there are younger leaders, leaders who he shares a wavelength with, who are in important and responsible positions of the All India Congress Committee. So there's absolutely no doubt about the fact that Nadeem Javed, I beg your pardon, is someone who enjoys the confidence of Congress president Rahul Gandhi. So it is perhaps incumbent on the party to come out and now clarify, as far as these very serious charges are concerned, about the serious of them. Are they political in nature? Are they correct? Are they incorrect? Was there actually a sum given at these two locations of 3 crores in Defence Colony and 7 crores in Lucknow?
So money given in 2 installments, that's at least the claim. 3 crores was the first installment, 7 crores the next. Shehzad Poonawalla, political analyst now with me on the phone line. Shehzad, how do you see this?
I think that now Rahul Gandhi, to whom a letter has been written by these people, must come out and answer. This is the kind of corruption that exists under his patronage, under his watch. He's very eager to ask questions on Rafael deal, and he must ask these questions. But when he himself has to answer these questions on National Herald, and you know, Rahul Shivshankar and Times now has shown how the documents revealed, the Exhibit 22 also yesterday, you all have shown how a Hawala company was used to take the loan for Young India. Now, these questions, which are inconvenient when it's happening under his watch, Chidambaram scam, ASL Maxis scam, where charge sheets have been filed, on this Rahul Gandhi is, you know, eloquently silent. So I think now the time has come for Rahul Gandhi to answer these questions, if the Namdar is actually Imandar or not Imandar.
But there are many, Shehzad, who are questioning the letter. They are saying there is no date on the letter. We do not know when this letter was written to Rahul Gandhi. Did the letter actually reach him or not?
No, if it is not so, then Rahul Gandhi's office should issue a statement that we discount these charges. We have full faith in Nadeem Javed, and we therefore take this, reject it at the very outset. And Nadeem Javed should also come and clarify. But the fact is that they are all silent. And, you know, Feroz Khan issue also at this time, when a girl made a charge against the NHOA president. That time also Rahul Gandhi was silent. Now that girl has approached the police, she's filed a complaint. You remember the story of the social media cell, how Congress Party, one woman was being sexually exploited. She also filed an FIR. These are all things that were brought out in the public domain. Rahul Gandhi has remained silent on all these discrepancies happening within the Congress. Why doesn't he take a stand and issue a clarification and tell that, you know, which side he's on? Whether he's on the side of corruption, whether he's on the side of sexual exploitation within the Congress or not. He should come out and take a stand.
But Shehzad, what do you make of what is written in the letter actually? The charges allegedly are grave, because this says that Nadeem Javed promised to get him a license for the slaughterhouse.
So I think that these charges basically show that there is a culture in the Congress party where the hand is not one hand for the common man, but it's a hand for taking the bribes under the table, over the table, all kinds of bribes. And if it is not so, Nareen Javed should be asked to step down till the time an inquiry is held, till the time an FIR or whatever legal proceedings are taken forward. Once he gets a clean sheet, he can be brought back in position. That is the standard which is expected by Rahul Gandhi for the people in government. So why doesn't he set the standard? Why doesn't he take off Nareen Javed, allow an inquiry to take place, let there be doodh ka doodh pani ka pani.
Okay, so you want that Congress should sack Nareen Javed pending a probe. Tehsin, stay with us, Shehzad. Tehsin Poonawala, political analyst also on the show. Tehsin, how do you see this letter now hitting the Congress party?
This letter is nothing but a joke, because the Qureshis were in the BSP before. They have been closely associated with the BSP. Number two, who is Nareen Javed? Is he in power? It is Yogi's government that is fighting slaughterhouses. It is Yogi ji shutting it down. How can Nareen Javed open a slaughterhouse? Or is Yogi Adityanath, in the words of our nationalist, doing tushtikaran, and Nareen Javed can start a slaughterhouse? What are these stories? Anybody comes, creates a media sensation and becomes a story.
Okay, just 1 minute. Madhav Das Gopalakrishna, our senior editor, wants to come in. Madhav.
Tehsin, the letter very clearly mentions, and just like to inform you, that a bribe of 3 crores was paid at his residence D-266 Defence Colony on 24th of July 2015. There was not a BJP government that was present at that point of time in Uttar Pradesh. There was a Samajwadi Party government where this person had reason to believe that this individual, Mr. Nareen Javed, had considerable influence.
Okay, so the bribe was paid in 2015.
Yes, the first half.
What was the Qureshis doing?
That's exactly what he's saying. He was waiting for 3 years to get this work done.
Go file a civil case against him or a criminal case. What is the point of writing a letter to Rahul Gandhi? Tomorrow I will write a letter that Obama took money from me to Modi ji. Does that make sense? I mean, there has to be some evidence. No, money has to have a money link. There has to be a money trail. It has to lead to some evidence.
There are also pictures. There are also pictures of Nareen Javed at that location outside what appears to be India Islamic Center in Lodhi Road, the national capital, where he is running away from these individuals when he is confronted on these charges. There is video. It is running on air on Times Now. You can perhaps have a look at that as well. Clearly, Mr. Nareen Javed is running away from something.
Yeah, but I mean, I'm not going to defend Nareen, but I mean, a mob of people, I can see the visuals on Times Now. Just now, mob of people come to me in my car, I will also move away.
All right, Madhav, we'll have to leave it at that. Tehsin Poonawala, Shehzad, I thank you for that. A quick break, news continues. Stay with us.